Coming back to the product lifecycle, when the product leaves the factory, it travels to the customer site where it'll be operated, monitored, and serviced. What was once digital has now taken on a physical form factor, which means the rules for changing it, or for managing it, changed dramatically. Let me explain. When the product was just a digital idea managed in our Windchill system, it's easy to change. An engineering change can be implemented against any component or system, and like magic, all future products that use that component or system will change accordingly. But once a product becomes physical, if you want to change it, you need a technician with a wrench and replacement parts and a truck to carry them out to the site. The technicians will need to separately visit each and every individual product you want changed. And some of the products will be changed and some won't, meaning that you'll have different configurations and they might be distributed all over the world. So at any point, some products are changed, some aren't, which means that even when multiple serial numbers are manufactured identically, because each serial number has been exposed to different usage conditions and received different field changes and repairs over time, they evolve to be increasingly different. That's why, for physical products, you have to track the configuration of each and every as-maintained serial number separately. And in order to keep the records up to date, you have to be involved in the service process, where the action happens, so that you can capture what changed. This is where ServiceMax fits in. Many of you are aware that PTC recently invested nearly $1.5 billion to acquire ServiceMax. It's the largest acquisition in PTC's history, and I could not be more excited about it. We made the ServiceMax acquisition for two main reasons. First, we know how important service strategies are to many of our customers as a driver of revenue and profit growth. In many cases, the product can generate 10 times more revenue over its life than it did through the initial product sale. Many companies have products installed all over the world, and they might employ an order of magnitude more service technicians than engineers. Secondarily, and this is where I get excited, the addition of ServiceMax allows PTC to complete our vision for a closed-loop, model-based digital thread across the full product lifecycle from initial idea through a lifetime of use in the field. Focusing on service needs is not new to PTC. Long before ServiceMax, we've been building a service lifecycle management, or SLM, suite that already includes Arbortext, Servigistics, ThingWorks, and Vuforia. Customers tell me they're excited about what ServiceMax adds to PTC's SLM capabilities. So to share more about that, I'd like to welcome Neil Barua, the CEO of ServiceMax and now president of the full SLM business at PTC. Neil?
Thanks, Jim. Super excited. This truly is a remarkable time at PTC, with all the energy directed towards building world-class businesses and products, and then making sure customers get the most out of those products. Make no mistake about it. With the moves PTC has made, we're the only company, bar none, that has under one roof more than 30 years of expertise helping customers both develop and service products. We have a unique blueprint for excellence that can help you truly take that big leap toward next generation business models, but it's just not having the experience to know what great looks like. We have the full portfolio of technologies and solutions to get you there. ServiceMax brings a long list of new customers into the PTC fold, but there are also many ServiceMax customers that are already using CAD, PLM, SLM, IoT, and AR capabilities from PTC, which really speaks to the alignment between our offerings and the synergies we could develop together. One of the common customers that we've been working closely with since the acquisition is Schneider Electric, a company with 128,000 employees in 100 countries. Schneider's purpose is to empower everyone to make the most of our energy and resources, bringing progress and sustainability for all. They call this Life is On. with a huge and complex customer and asset base, and a longtime ServiceMax user, and a longtime user of Creo and Windchill upstream as well. We've already been discussing with Schneider the benefits of linking ServiceMax and Windchill together, marrying the full digital representation of their products with the physical assets out in the field. Later this morning, I'll be joined on stage during my SLM keynote by Jean-Pierre Cimillo, Schneider's VP of Service Digital Experience, to discuss their asset-centric service strategy in more detail, including their near-term focus to link service and IoT data to become more predictive while unlocking new services. He'll share how they see a great deal of value in bringing service and asset data back to PLM to close the loop and strengthen their design for serviceability ambitions. I can't wait to see what they do next. Aligning the product and service parts of the PTC portfolio creates new superpowers for our customers, whether you're Schneider or any other industrial company with product service needs. You will benefit from our new vision for service, an asset-centric model that we are developing to power our newly integrated SLM portfolio. We call this an asset-centric vision because the as-maintained asset definition acts as the hub, serving as the integration point that pulls together the powerful capabilities of the spokes. This approach is unique in our industry and critical to servicing complex products with different configurations. Windchill provides access to the initial service bill of material for each new product, along with a detailed 3D digital twin. Likewise, Salesforce CRM provides a 360-degree view of the customer. As the hub in the center, ServiceMax manages the as-maintained record of the install base, which customers understand which products they own and what their service entitlements are. This includes information about each product's configuration, prior issues, previous maintenance, parts replacements, and so forth. ThingWorx IoT allows ServiceMax to monitor the product fleet to enable service to be more predictive and preventive in nature, and in many cases, to be done remotely. Leveraging as-maintained product configuration data in ServiceMax with content in Windchill, ArborTex can deliver technical service documentation such as parts catalogs and work instructions specifically configured to match each asset. Similarly, blending ServiceMax configurations with Windchill content, Vuforia enables a service technician or even the end customer to see the 3D service instructions augmented right into the product. ServiceMax handles all the necessary field service management activities, such as the logistics of scheduling, dispatching field technicians, et cetera. And with deeper insight into actual service events occurring across the fleet, Servigistics can further optimize spare part costs, saving customers lots of money by reducing spare part inventories to the minimum level necessary to meet service level agreements. This strategy, made possible by combining the strengths of PTC and ServiceMax, ushers in the era of a service organization that is predictive and remote first, resource optimized, customer focused, and most importantly, commercially sustainable. For the ServiceMax and SLM team, LiveWorx is a great chance to show all of you what's possible for your service and digital strategies. So we hope to see you at the breakout sessions and in the service section of Extropolis over the next few days. I can't wait to show you the path we're already blazing with some of our customers. Jim, back to you.
All right. Thanks, Neil.